sleep it up so.
Is everyone just solo or you can save the eyes?
Blue is the color of the sky.
summer. Oh, a sigh comes cold, but
much.
Thank you guys very much. I'm a little tiny to tell her, no, I'm a little stressed out for me. How's everyone doing?
Good.
My name is Mel Leonard, and I'll be your MC for the evening. Thank you. You might remember me from every single other rally of troops where I show up 5 minutes before I have to play and then cry and then leave. And that's every year. This year's different, though. This year's different for me. And more on that why later, I guess. But anyway, so thank you for being here at Northern United Place for the 6th annual Rally of Troops. 6 years. I'd like to thank our sponsors, United, Adult Life United Church, for the venue. It's a wonderful venue. Thank you, guys. Pedo Productions, our wonderful sound guy. Thank you very much. Do not offer him any carrots. He doesn't like those.
Raw carrots.
Raw carrots. Cooked is okay.
Cooked are fine.
And our final sponsor is Folk on the Rocks, which I'm excited about. Folk on the Rocks is providing as a door prize tonight two deluxe tickets to Folk on the Rocks. If you don't know what deluxe means, it means you get to hang out and be a rock star. I think that means you get to be backstage and do whatever the heck you want all weekend long, hang with the cool kids. It's fantastic. It really kind of changes your experience for the weekend, so I'm glad to know some people here are going to win that. Some person or people. I don't know how it works. Maybe I should have read my notes more. There is a 50-50 draw. I believe that is the door prize for the 50-50 draw. No, it's a 50-50 draw and a door prize. Good.
Yeah.
That's not a 50-50 draw. It's a prize. There are two prizes. Yeah.
And you can also get photo
number. Half the money. So I don't know who's selling tickets. I believe you're selling these lovely people right here at the bucket. And so get your 50-50 tickets. I'd also like to point out in the back, there are luminaries, which is a fancy way of saying candles, I think. That's right. those are to honor the survivors, right? Correct. And remembering people who've, every battle has lost soldiers, I guess, and we're honoring those people as well. So those are a dollar. We have a very special deal. If you happen to be a millionaire, they're $5,000 each. If you happen to be a millionaire. I'm just under. So I'll pay a dollar for one. But if you want to show off, $5,000, that's how much it is. I would like to welcome you all here. Thank you for showing up here. It's very important that we're all here, not only to remember the people that we've lost to cancer, people who we've know that have been touched by cancer, but to also honor the survivors, which is why I'm here today and why I'm okay with being here today. Because for too many years, it was not about the survivors for me, which was cheating the survivors, I think. But the survivors are very important, and they're the reason why we still fight, and there's some great survivors here in this room. Oddly enough, right before I showed up here, I got a call from my brother who told me he has a tumor on his bladder. So that's typical of my brother, he does everything first. Before me, I'm 40, so it's been, it's that time of my life where I start thinking about that stuff. He's gonna be fine. It's because he's a fighter as well, so just thought I'd bring that up. But let me tell you a little bit about how this whole thing started. Back in 2012, at the Relay for Life, that was at the William Mack Field. I don't know if you remember this, Sherry, but I was there.
No.
I was there, and I was there for the sole purpose, other than to support people, I was there to draw all the mosquitoes to me, which is what I did all night long. They all fell on me, and you guys didn't even know there was mosquitoes there. At that event, the Rainbow Launette's team captain, Sheree, met fellow survivor Amanda Dye while they were walking the survivor's lap together, and I remember that lap very vividly. And you, I think that was maybe the first time I really met you, but you don't remember me, that's okay. Amanda, more commonly known as Mandy No Pants, to those who know her, and if you know her, you know why. She hated pants, orange popsicles, and cancer, in that order. So she was known as Mandy No Pants, and she was part of the No Pants Army team. And she lost her battle to ovarian cancer the following spring. But her spirit, which is strong, lives on. And oddly enough, that was in 2013. And it dawned on me very recently. I was very close to Amanda. We were songwriting partners. We were everything together. And she was a big, big part of my life, especially here in Yellowknife. And I met her in 2008 when I moved back from a very failed stint at Drawn. And literally the night I moved back into town, I met Amanda. We struck a bond, and that bond lasted and still lasts today. But the entirety of the chunk that she takes up in my life and my heart is massive. And that was a 5-year period. It's been 5 years now since she's passed. And it was a little bit strange to realize that more time had passed since I've known her, since she passed, than I've known her in her entirety. And that is a testament to the way people embed in your heart and how strong they are well after they're gone. So it's kind of cool. It's bittersweet, but it's cool to know that that's still as strong. I can still hear her voice and I can still sing along with her. 5 years later, and in 15 years, I'm sure it'll be the same thing. Anyway, back to the story. The following year after that, Amy O'Connor was the No Pants Army kind of team captain. She was amazing as well, and she approached Cherie about carrying on Mandy's fighting spirit, and they teamed up the following year to help to hold the first ever Rally of the Troops, which has grown into this, what you see today. And I'd like to thank Cherie for that as well. And also, a shout out to Amy, who also lost a battle with cancer as well, not long after that. So thank you, Amy. I know she's watching. Anyway. To open tonight's program, we're going to actually ask Cherie to come on up and do a little something, I believe. And Ryan, of course. I didn't know if you wanted to introduce Ryan. Ryan McCord, or there he is, back in the back. I'm going to be here for the whole thing because I really wanted to see this. So ladies and gentlemen, Cherie McPherson and Ryan McCord. Thank you.
friends. How are you guys?
Yeah.
That didn't sound too enthusiastic. Sorry if my sunglasses fall off. They're not very good at staying on inside. Let's just see these words. Okay. Nope, we're not allowed auto scrolling. One second. I'm loving. Anyway.
Do you want me to move that closer to your.
No, I'm good. I can see it. I'm just going to have to. So hi guys, my name is Sheree McPherson. I know most of you, I think, but if I don't know you, hi, nice to meet you. I am the founder of the Rainbow Lodettes. It was me and like 10 of my middle school friends who got together in grade 6, 7, something like that. And I've always had a relay team ever since. Even before I was able to have a relay team. But in grade 6 or 7, we were like, yeah, let's do this real hard. So we got a logo made. This is our logo. I think we named him Belly Button. And we made this banner with our grade 8 art teacher. We had a really good time. We got shirts and we went all out. But yeah, that was fun. So I'm the founder of the Rainbow Lodettes, and a lot of people ask me, where'd your name come from? Well, that's what I'm gonna tell you. So, we're gonna dip way back to 2003. Dad's always got your back. If you don't know, in 2003, in September, I was diagnosed with a form of kidney cancer, childhood kidney cancer. So, yeah, that was rough. But, so we were in Edmonton, and I was about to have a surgery, and I was mildly petrified, like most people are before their first surgery. So my dad took me down. It's a Stollery Children's Hospital in Edmonton. I don't know if you've ever been there. It's also the U of A Hospital, more commonly known as. Just ginormous, high ceilings, gorgeous, most least depressing hospital in the world. And my dad took me down to the atrium with these giant high ceilings, and we sat on the stairs beside a fountain. And because it was 2 o'clock in the morning, all the big lights were off, but there were the fountain lights, and you know what happens when light hits water? It makes a rainbow. And I was like, wow, rainbows are cool. So now I really like rainbows a lot, and most people know that. People send me rainbow selfies when they see rainbows, and which is great. So if you ever see a rainbow, just know that rainbows can get you through anything. So this song is The Rainbow Connection. Everyone knows it. Kermit the Frog. Ryan and I are gonna play it. We just practiced for like 30 seconds in the hall, so. Yeah.
I don't think I really knew it before we played it together that other time.
Yeah, Ryan taught me a Rainbow Connection. Like,
she got me to learn it so I could teach it to her.
That was a while ago. I think that was like our second rally of troops. Maybe even the first. So, and I don't think we played it since then together, so please bear with us. But this is the Rainbow Connection. By the Muppets. Maybe? Yes.
Choose to believe it. I know they're all
Thank you very much. That was beautiful. All right. I think it's time for our survivor ceremony. So what I'm going to do is, if you feel like it, I'm not going to pressure anybody, but if you are a survivor, feel free to sit up in the front row. In the first couple of rows, if you like. Cancer is a scary journey, and sometimes we're stuck in the dark not knowing what lies ahead. But these survivors are the light that guides us. I think everyone here is a survivor in some way or another, but they give us hope. You're here today to show us why it's important to continue the fight against cancer. And I'm going to ask Patrick Scott to come up here, if you could, and say a few words. Thank you, Patrick.
Good evening. For those who don't know me, I'm the father of 8 children. My wife, Gabriel, is here with me this evening. I was diagnosed with cancer in 2013 and went through treatment. And in 2016, I was having some bad indicators, so I went, had some tests done, and went to see my oncologist, and he very seriously sat me down and looked at me and said, "I hate to tell you, but it's come back." And he said, "You're only about 5% of people who've gone through what you've gone through get cancer again." And I looked at him and said, "I finally made it to the top of the class." No. And he didn't even react. I was really disappointed. When I sat down, I don't see her right now. There's a young girl sitting in front of me with a green t-shirt. And I just happened to notice on the back of the t-shirt it said, "It is not the strongest of the species that survive or the most intelligent, but the ones most responsive to change." Cancer survivors respond to change, and that's why we survive. Because we face a huge change in our lives when we get diagnosed. And we have people like Sherry, who keeps on trucking and stands up in front of people year after year and encourages us all to keep going. And it's that kind of inspiration, facing all the changes that she's facing, and now she's in for another whole change in her world as she goes off to university or college, wherever it is she ends up, and she's going to keep going. And that's what kind of hope that Leonard just mentioned. That's what it's all about. And one of the things that I found in my journey is one of the richest kinds of treatment that we get as we truck on is the love of those of our family and people around us. That's what really helps us survive. That's what makes our journey meaningful and important. When people reach out with love, touch us physically, emotionally, spiritually, and it gives us strength, and we in turn can carry our journey forward knowing that we are loved and we can love others. And that's what it's all about. Any other survivors want to come up and join me? Come on, Shelly. At least you. Who are our survivors? At least stand up if you don't want to come forward. Or wave your arm, do something.
Yeah. Well, we have Sharon.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. And all the best for your journey, girl. So I know there's lots more in the Yellowknife community, but here's 4 trucking on, and we're going to keep on trucking.
As most of you know, if you've been to some of my family members who were diagnosed with cancer before I was in the year 2000, but the majority of them are people I met here in Yellowknife who were on that cancer train and had it off very early. So we are lucky. We're still on it.
Thank you very much for that. Thank you, Patrick, as well. And I'd like to point out that eight children, you are ready for anything. There is nothing that can knock you down. Well, thank you for that. So we're going to move on with our musical performance again, if we could. One more time, I'd like to point out the luminaries in the back for sale for $1, which is a super cheap way to honor people, and 50-50 tickets, which I'm going to get some as soon as I step off stage, if that's okay with you. All right. Up next, yes, I just mentioned the candles. I call them luminaries. It's a fancy word I made up. anyway, one of my favorite Yellowknife performers is up next. I've played with them many times, and probably more than anyone that's still around anyway. Please welcome to the stage, Darren Woodbury.
What I can say is that just about everybody that I've ever met who's gone through it has been, whether they've survived or not, have been the strongest, the most amazing people that you'll ever see. Because they're always in question of their mortality. And I don't mean to be maudlin by any means. Please don't take it like that. These people are incredible. The people who are survivors, you guys here, are survivors. Pat yourselves on the back every day, every night. Because people like me don't know what you've gone through. We can only watch it. The best I can do is work in support to try to help you guys through it. Who are going through it, the people who have gone through it. But the No Pants Army is concerned, Amanda Dye was, she was one of my best friends. One of the greatest loves of my life. This is a song I used to play with her band, my first band here in Yellowknife. That sounds good, thank you, that's wonderful. If anybody hasn't talked about him, you guys know who this guy is over here. He's making all of us sound great tonight. Thank you so much. I'm going to play a song that she and I sang together in my first band here in Yellowknife, a band called Love Gut, which is kind of a hard rock kind of deal, but this is a little bit of a different version than the one that I played with her. Some of you may have heard it. For those of you who haven't, it's just a stupid rock song, so don't put anything else into it, okay?
Did you turn it off?
Nope.
Okay, I lost you. was terrible.
It was. You had it going. You had it going, Jared.
Yeah, it was terrible.
Was a featherland fracture that brought me to my knees. Was a modern method actor who showed me my disease. So much time in question and no time spent being high. So I put on my bravest face and waved the sweetest bye-bye. I've been sleeping with all the angels, feeling like a spy. She's one of the brightest angels, still I made her cry. I've been sleeping with all the angels, feeling like a dirty little spy. She's one of the brightest angels, still I made her cry. Says she wants to wake up in paradise, just because it makes her smile. I'll take away all her heartaches, throw it heavy on a pile. I wanna wake up a changed man, I'll never have to ask that big one. Wanna wake up in the water, just to catch that rising sun, yeah. I've been sleeping with all the angels, feeling like a spy. She's one of the brightest angels, still I made her cry. I've been sleeping with all the angels, feeling like a goddamn spy. She's one of the brightest angels, still I made her cry. Still I made her cry, and I'm feeling like a spy.
I'm gonna play a little number that is probably horribly, horribly cliche in so far as everybody has played this song. Everybody and their dog has played this song. Everybody and their dog's hamster has played this song. But I'm gonna play this song because a long, long time ago when I was 15 years old, when I first started playing the guitar, when I first learned how to play the guitar, it was one of the first songs I ever learned how to play. And another friend of mine was passing. And I played this song for him on his deathbed. And because of this song, because he liked this song somehow, some way, maybe it was the Buddhist in him, maybe it was the power of fighting against what you got. He was able to get up out of bed for about 2 months, and he went to Tibet, and that's where he passed. It's where he wanted to die. But I'm gonna play this song strictly because I always play this song for him, and I think this event is very important. And just remember the people that we've gone through this with, and the people who are still going through it. Thank you. It's hard to talk right now.
Must be some kind of way out of here. So that you went to the thief. It's too much confusion. I can't get no relief. And a businessman, they drink my wife. Plowmen dig my earth. And none of them know along these lines. it's worth it. No reason to get excited.
Through fiddler's green.
does know so. And there's nowhere that he's really been. And he won't travel alone. No, not in Fiddler's Green.
Say thank you very much to Mel for everything that he talks about, the fact that he's going to be able to do this now and forever, whether he likes it or not, because he's just that cool. And again, we'd like to say thank you very much to Indio, who's over there on the soundboard. Without him, my sound would be garbage. With him, I sound like recyclables. This next song I'm going to play is actually a song about Yellowknife in the summertime. I'm only telling you this because if I don't, you're going to think it's about a girl. But I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
A love song ever floating on the wind. And there's no place like home to show you the places you've been. Break my heart, break my heart. Said you always break my heart. Sweet halo around my window pane. Such serenity I've never fallen to. And there's no words to be spoken, spoken. Falling suddenly for you. Break my heart. Break my heart. Said you always break my heart.
Hey, he's got a guitar.
Are you going to play with me or am I going to play?
All right. Thank you very much. I appreciate it, ladies and gentlemen.
Your host and
a musician.
I'm honored.
Appreciate you, Darren. It's an incredibly difficult thing to do this, to talk and perform when you're emotional, and it's a bravery of its own. So thank you very much, Darren Woodbury. Have another round of applause for Darren Woodbury. I met Darren at the same time I met Amanda, actually. They were in a band together, like you said, called Love Gun. And
Darren, is this your cable?
Fortunate enough to get to play with her as well, so. Our next act needs no introduction, because it's me, so, and I'm not really a big fan of me, so I'm not going to talk about him.
Holy God, jeez, you guys are such downers.
Such downers. Yeah, yeah. I'm happy to be here and play a few songs for you, and I'm going to play a song by Amanda Dye, if that's cool with you, as I always do. Thank you very much, sir. I will say this, I'm not going to beat myself up because Amanda Dye made me a good performer and a good songwriter by the virtue of her poetic heart, and I carry her gifts with me all the time. I always said after she passed that I had half a voice, but that was a lie because I still have her in my heart, and I still feel like when I'm singing with her, so we're going to do a song for you. How about that? This is a song she wrote called How You Sleep, which I think I play every single year.
It's not with me.
Oh, no, no, no. I don't know how you sleep, but it's not with me. It's not with me. Oh, no, no, no. Does the things for you that I could never do, 'cause I think you should know happiness and we were nowhere near that. Hope that when you think about me now you understand I can be a better man if I just learn from the mess that the two of us made. I don't know how you sleep, but it's not with me. It's not with me. Oh, no, no, no. I don't know how you sleep, but it's not with me. It's not with me. Oh, no, no, no. Baby,
no easy way out. Hey, yeah, stand my ground, and I won't back down.
So I keep promising you I'll play Architect. Maybe this is the time.
That's what awesome.
And you're gonna play it too? You don't know how to play it? Alright, I'm gonna try it. How about this? I'm not gonna do it as good as Amanda did it. This is a song that Amanda wrote as well. And it's the one she won the 48-hour music competition with. Song right here. Oddly enough, that's serendipity right there. And it's called Architect, and I'll do what I can. This one's for you.
Let you understand. I can be your architect. Let me be your man. Wonderful caregivers. It's one of the things I love about this town. Literally, anything you need is not that far away in Yellowknife. And many of you here tonight fall in that category too, so let me say a personal thank you to you guys who show up and support these kind of events and the people that are in them. And I don't know how somehow Charisse manages to be in every single category. We have a survivor and a caregiver, but she is definitely both. I'm not going to talk anymore for a little while because I need to collect my thoughts here. And I'm going to ask Corey, who's much more articulate than me, to come on up. Your MLA for Yellowknife North, Mr. Corey Bantai.
Thank you, everybody. And sure, it's a pleasure to be here once again. As Mel indicated, I'm the representative tonight that's going to speak a little bit about caregivers. And I lost my mom to the battle of cancer back in 2003. My mom lost her battle to a cancer called non-small cell lung cancer. And I'll come back to that maybe a little bit later. I just want to acknowledge, first of all, a couple of people because the cancer kind of caring community of Yellowknife, which is vast, does have a number of characters that you see at every event in Yellowknife. And I was a relayer for 13 years, and some of the people that I see in this room were there that whole time. But in particular, Sheree is a longtime relayer,
And if there's anybody in this room that's arguably given more to the cause, it's our good friend Judith sitting out in the back, doing what she always does. Tonight she's selling luminaries and other things there, so let's support her. So I tried to, well, first of all, maybe I'll just touch quickly on how it was that I kind of came across Cherie's path. And that was, every year I tried to set a little goal for myself as a relayer. Some years it was a kind of a, you know, maybe a physical achievement, maybe stay on the track for 45 minutes of every hour. And those were tough years. I tried to do that. That's tougher than you'd think. And then other years I would reach out to people. And one year in particular, I asked survivors to walk around with me around the laps there, around the track at William McDonald. And one of the survivors was Cherie, and she told me, she was just, you know, this big at the time, and she told me about her story of survival, and her, much like she is today, it was a positive message. It was for sure all about hope, and most certainly it was about being a winner and winning this fight against cancer. And here we are all these years later, and nothing's changed. Cherie is here doing exactly what she was doing then, giving positive messages, advocating for hope, and being a winner. So, thank you, Cherie. Yes, indeed. We're all here tonight because of her. And so, on to caregivers. I was trying to think about, you know, it's easy, as Indio has kind of noticed, that sometimes when you're talking about cancer, the mood can kind of be a little somber. And so I was wondering to myself, well, how am I going to do this tonight? You know, is it going to be similar to my speech last year where it was kind of more emotional? And I told more about my story of being a caregiver for my mom and the struggles that I had in dealing with that. Should I maybe do a comic kind of skit, maybe make it a little bit more humorous? And really what I came up with was kind of a top 10 list type theme, and what I'm entitling it is really the 6 rules for caregivers. And these come from, not rules that I even had at the time when I was caregiving or taking care of my mom, but maybe more like lessons that I had learned from that experience. And so, without further ado, let's move on to 6 rules for caregivers. Okay, caregiver rule number 1. You will be scared. By no means is this a normal situation. There is no practice for this life-altering experience. There is no one road map to cancer care, and care teams often seem to speak a foreign language. So you must ask questions. You and your loved ones need and deserve to know exactly what the care team has in mind. Remember, knowledge is the antidote to fear. So ask, ask, ask. Don't be afraid to ask those questions. Caregiver rule number 2. There will be gross stuff. Accept it. Caregiving is more than hand-holding. It is a hard, gut-wrenching work. It is a hard, gut-wrenching experience. Stuff that belongs on the inside of the human body is now at times going to be on the outside. In those moments, remember that you are there for your cancer warrior. Throw on your own armor for a moment and sort out your feelings later. Your cancer warrior needs your full attention. Complete the mission. Caregiver rule number 3. You will receive unsolicited and unwanted advice. Deflect it. You'll hear about a diet or the best clinic or this friend of mine, and it'll come down to 3 different kinds of people. The well-intended, they want to offer you help, but they don't know how. They're kind of scared too. Treat them gently and say with a smile, "Thank you for sharing that. We have our medical care team to handle these issues." The know-it-alls says, "My cousin had the same cancer and she did X, Y, Z, and are you doing X, Y, Z? She made it, you know, she's a 3-year cancer survivor." Firmly and pleasantly, and again with a smile, say, "We're glad your cousin is doing well. We have our medical care team to handle these issues. And then, there are the pushy and self-righteous. These people are sometimes offensive, and you will need to find a civil way to say, shut up. So you say, we have our care team to handle that, and we have no interest in hearing about this from you again, but this time, no smile. That's sometimes a difficult one to deal with, but everyone has advice, and they come in, and it comes in different forms. Caregiver rule number 4, take care of yourself. My whole speech last year up here was about that, because of the personal experiences that I had, the difficulties that I struggled with in being a caregiver. So it's that important, I say it again, take care of yourself. I know it seems simple, but it's not. Caring for a loved one is demanding both physically and emotionally. Get some fresh air and exercise, get outside, whatever moves you. Whether it's a bike ride, a run, a trail hike, some fishing, some golf, whatever you can do to get moving. And you will need this, believe me, yeah, I mean it. And of course, allow yourself the courtesy of emotions. This caregiver business is hard stuff. And so you're not weak when you cry. You know, as we talked about earlier today, the emotion can be somber at some times and certainly overwhelming. And so being sad is fine. And so is being happy. And sometimes in order to do that, you need to find some support. And so it's good if you can reach out and find a support group. There are plenty of them, and some of them are even online. Get out there with your friends. Go for a night out and maybe go to the movies or what have you. As a caregiver, you deserve a break. So, which leads us to number 5. Ask for help. What you do as a caregiver is simply exhausting. You cannot do this alone. You need to be honest with yourself and what you can do. So, delegate. You're surrounded by a bunch of people who want to help, but they have no idea, and I mean none, at what you need done. The old military saying is, when placed in charge, take command. You are in charge. It's okay to say, I need you to go to the grocery store. It's good to say, would you please stay with my mom for an hour this afternoon while she naps so I can go for a walk? Friends and family do want to help, so again, ask for help. And the last rule for caregivers, trust yourself. No one set of caregiver guidelines is correct. You and you alone know your own circumstances better than anyone. Give yourself permission to trust your judgment. Caregivers who are more confident are better able to care for their loved ones. You are smart, you are capable, you are worthy of this great thing. Finally, when you are with your loved ones, listen with all your heart. Your cancer warrior needs you strong, needs your humor, and needs your wisdom, and needs your touch. Regardless of how this cancer journey turns out, you will exit at the other end a person of greater wisdom, compassion, and heart. You can do this. So, there you have it. Those are my 6 rules for caregivers. Before I depart the stage, I do have a couple positive announcements to make as it relates to the fight against cancer. One is, as I mentioned earlier, that my mom lost her battle in 2003 to a disease called non-small cell lung cancer. This is a form of cancer that's commonly affiliated with smoking and or secondhand smoke. And of course, in the day, not long ago, it was virtually a death sentence, quite frankly, as many cancers are. I'm happy to tell you that in recent years, there has been a surgery now for stage 0 and stage 1 of non-small lung cancer that actually can lead to a cure for this particular type of cancer. And now there is also a oral treatment that is more recently being used to avoid the surgery part for those same 2 stages of non-small cell lung cancer. So that's a fantastic news as it relates to the fight against cancer. Second is, and more recently, as Mel let you know, I am the
member of the Legislative Assembly for Yellowknife North. And in our recent session, which just wrapped up on Friday, I was proud to put a motion forward that passed unanimously by the full entire House to ban smoking in vehicles with minors in it. And so, we hope that that will turn into law. It's got to go through its due diligence process, but we hope that that will turn into law sometime before the end of this assembly. So I'm very happy that I got that support. It's sad that we in fact have to bring these kinds of laws forward, because you would think that that would be common sense, but unfortunately we do, and so we will see that coming forward in the next couple of years. So thanks again, once again, for having me. Big hand for Cherie. We're going to miss her as she moves on to another stage in her life. And thank you all for being here. Have a good night. Thank you very much, Corey Vantine. I'm very happy to hear about that proposed law. I hope it goes through to flying colors. As a child who grew up in the back seat of a smoking car. That is my fault. That is my fault. I can't believe this is totally my fault. We skipped a performer. Sorry, Corey. And I would like to personally apologize to Grace Clark, because I was not in a good headspace when I finished, and I just went ahead and totally bypassed you. So let's bring Grace Clark up to the stage right now. I'm done. Thank you.
And this next song is called Don't Look Back.
You're my soul.
2012. They're a group that gets together once a month jam, and we're lucky to have a few members here with us tonight. And they're going to play a couple of well-known songs. I was lucky enough to hear the sound check, and it was wonderful, and I can't wait to hear it in its full glory. So I'm going to let one of these guys already, the Guitar Circle Band, introduce themselves, but in the meantime, why don't you make them feel welcome to the stage? Give them a big round of applause. Also, one more time, I'd like to thank our sponsors, and that is the United Church for the venue here. Also, Pedo for their wonderful sound production. Thank you, Indio. And as well, because Ryan and Ashley are sitting in the back, Folk in the Rocks, who are providing a very kick-ass prize that we're going to draw at the end of the night, and that is deluxe tickets for two for the entire weekend for Folk in the Rocks. Deluxe tickets. You are basically hanging out with the stars. Literally, the stars. Because the band, the stars, are. Anyway. You're not here. You're not. I know you're not here. I'm already sad about it. Thanks for bringing it back up.
No, you make me sad because I'm the star.
I know. You are the star. You will hang out with the stars. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, the Guitar Circle Band.
Hello, folks. I'm just going to like stand up on the mic quick before we start. I just want to thank Patrick for his amazing speech that made my heart all fuzzy inside. And everyone who is here, there's Dad's like, I want to put out chairs so we know how many people we're going to have. I'm like, Dad, nobody sit down. And he's like, no, we're going to put a lot of chairs to see how many people we have. Yet, 50% of you are standing. I was right. But I want to thank all of you who came, especially those who are here. And yeah. And this band, I'm very thankful for this band. We meet every time. I mean, every Sunday, not every... We meet once a month on Sundays, and it's... I miss gymnastics to go to this, so it must be a big deal. They're really great people. Most of us have been in it since the beginning, I think. Yeah. Pretty close. We've had a few ups and downs since then, but
we're doing good. So, are we ready? Is everyone ready?
Are we ready? Are we on the table?
If you're playing in G, yeah.
I'm just writing her.
Just need a place where I can lay my head.
by the band. Very creative. And this next song is Lean On Me, which you all know. So sing along. And there's a clapping part, like we'll guide you, but clap along, okay? Are you guys ready?
Thanks.
called Three Little Birds. That's what it's called. Three Little Birds by Bob Marley. Everyone also knows this one, so sing along.
Never stop doing that. So thank you very much, Guitar Circle. I'm going to ask Marino to come up to introduce our next performers, if that's okay with Marino. Do some advertising. I'm not going to advertise the company I work at. But, one more time, I would like to say there are 50-50 tickets, and your chances are very good of winning. So, best lottery odds probably in the world right now. Okay, oh, there we go. Yeah, no problem. So 50-50 tickets, get them because your chances of winning are pretty good and it goes for a great cause and half the money goes towards you. So that's also a great cause because you're worth it. Also, there are luminaries in the back for sale for $1 to honor survivors and people who have lost their fight with cancer. In addition to that, at the end of the evening, when we draw the 50-50 draw, we're also drawing for a prize from one of our sponsors, Folk in the Rocks. And once again, that is a deluxe pass. Is that for one or two people? Two people for all weekend long? Deluxe. Now, I've been saying this all night, but that means they get backstage access, right? They get everything. It's pretty fun, I have to say, to be backstage at both. It's like its own little mini festival behind the main stage that you get to be a part of, so I kind of hope you win that. So, get your tickets. It's the same tickets as 50-50, so if you lose 50-50, you win Folk in the Rocks prize if you're runner-up, so that's incredible chances to do something really cool with your money, and you're donating to a fantastic cause. And if you're curious as to how you can help, that's one way you can help, by giving money and maybe winning prizes. If you haven't seen this this program, by the way, there's been videos playing up here, and all the links to those YouTube videos are in the program if you want to take it home and look at them later, because with sound, it's cool. There's some great stuff there. So, and also it lists all the performers for tonight in case you don't know someone who performed. And yeah, so I'm going to ask Marino to introduce our next act, if he's ready. Excellent. Ladies and gentlemen, Marino.
So as you already gathered, Tom has been a vital part of our monthly music circle, and part of my time with the circle and with Cherie especially, I just wanted to make my own personal tribute to Cherie because she's graduating and then going to the University of Lethbridge, so my life is going to be changing soon. And I just wanted to share a part of many of the years because of trying to improve physical health and many other reasons. Cherie and I walked everywhere for a long time. And while we were walking, part of filling the time was we would sing songs that Marino wrote. Most of the songs Marino wrote in the last 20 years have never been on anyone else's ears other than Cherie. So we sang these songs together. So as a tribute to Cherie in this event that she's put so much energy in, Karen and Tom are going to do an interpretation of a song that I wrote called Paint the Day.
Thanks, Marino. We had a lot of fun learning this song. And it's a real honor for us to perform this song on behalf of Marino. He told us he would be too emotional to do it. Hopefully we will be okay.
Paint the
you. So we were asked to do a couple more songs on there. And we thought about a couple songs to do, and Tom actually suggested this one. And it's a song that we love performing all the time, and it seems to mean a lot to a lot of people. It's called Forever Young. John Fogerty. Rather new one. It was written, I guess, in his 60s, Tom?
Yeah, he actually, he just turned 75, I believe. 75? 73.
So there's no reason to quit doing whatever you're doing at any stage in your life. It's called Don't You Wish It Was True?
Take a moment to think about the impact cancer has had on your lives.
and the lives of your loved ones. If you look around, you'll see the room is lined with little cups. Each little cup has a light, and each light represents a different reason why we continue the fight against cancer. Some lights honor the survivors. Some are in memory of those who we've lost to cancer. Every one of them has a story to tell. In a few moments, we're going to dim the lights in here and give you a chance to see the light that each candle gives. I ask you to go and stand in front of your candle, your reason. And when I give the word, light your candle. Once all the candles are lit, we'll take a moment to read and remember all the stories of candles around the room. As you look around, all the candles, you can see that we have all been touched by cancer. Every child, every parent, every grandparent, every friend. And we, us collectively, everyone here in this room, are doing something about it. We are turning our sorrow into celebration. We are converting our loss into action. We have put faces and voices to this disease. Our mothers and fathers gave us the gift of life filled with hope. Now we are honoring or remembering a parent. Oh, we're not supposed to do that yet? Okay. Well, it's time for the song. I jumped the gun. Everybody, do what Cherie says.
the Guitar Circle Band of Quebec up on stage.
And Grace Clark.
And Grace Clark, who's just been nominated to the Guitar Circle Band. Apparently. By the way, one of the songs, we're going to finish with the fight song, and if you don't know what the fight song is, it's on the back of the program, if you need the lyrics, and you're encouraged to sing along loudly. The Washington Capitals are Stanley Cup champions. If you need a little dose of the minutia and the really unimportant stuff in life during a very important event. And Doug Ford is Premier of Ontario. Majority, too. Yeah. Aren't you glad you live in Yellowknife? Really? We've got people like Corey Banthine, and they've got Doug Ford, so I'm happy to be here.
Yay for Corey!
Should be on.
As far as I know, there is no Relay for Life this year, right?
No.
The that doesn't matter, because each one of you here tonight are fighters, and your goal when you leave here is to keep fighting, and how you fight is up to you, be it through being a caregiver. There may not be a relay, but you guys can still keep fighting all the time, and you are fighting, so thank you very much for that. And I'd like to thank all the performers for tonight for getting up here and playing as well. And also our sponsors, you know, the Yellowknife United Church for this venue again. Pedo, providing awesome sound and sound equipment, and a fantastic piano player as well. You don't get that everywhere else. I'm saying this is a truly Yellowknife thing. And finally, Folk in the Rocks. Speaking of Folk in the Rocks, I think it's time to do a little prize draw. What do you think? Where is our Bucket O' Tickets? Bucket O' Tickets. So here's the only rule. A, you had to have purchased a ticket. And B, you have to be here to win. I think that's fair.
I think that's fair.
Right? So our runner-up prize is first, and that is brought to you by Folk on the Rocks. So how about we get Ashley to come up and draw this prize?
There's multiple Ashleys here. It's that Ashley that matters.
The only folk in Ashley that matters. I said it. Folk, come on. All right. Our number is 6906822. 822, the last three numbers. 822. Get your tickets. These red ones right here.
Dave!
Dave!
I don't
even
know. Yeah, Dave works at
folks. So if somebody wants to buy it and donate the money, they can have it.
Or, is that what you want to do?
Yeah, or draw.
Or we draw it again.
But have you got Dave's ticket back in?
Make another draw. We'll do that. It's about winners. And that's very kind of you, Dave. Thank you very much. Sorry, you left prematurely. This time around, it is 845. Last three numbers, 845. Come on up here. You get deluxe passes for two all weekend long at Folk. That saves you a considerable sum of money. Where are you going to Folk anyway? Now you're going in style. I'll see you backstage hanging out with the stars.
I can't sing though.
All right. And now, so did you count the money?
I did.
You did. How much is our prize?
$140.
You guys are generous people. All right. So, Cherie, would you like to draw this one? She's kind of magic like that. Eight, one, four.
Someone that came early.
Are $140 out. Because they left. They gave up the fight.
Yeah, okay.
All right, let's draw another one. $140 would probably also get you some passes to Folk in the Rocks.
For one day.
That second prize is starting to look pretty good right now, isn't it?
It's a weekend.
I know.
One weekend pass.
That's great. That's what I was trying to say. No, I said the first prize, the cash, would buy a ticket for one day. Would it?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm wrong. Either way, you still won't get to hang out backstage. Unless you bribe someone $140. 829 is the number. 829.
Wendy!
Congratulations, Wendy. Who said musicians don't get paid?
I did.
That's fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here tonight. The fight is important, and you are all awesome for being here. Continue being awesome all year long.
And thank you very, very much. Have a good night.
higher.
Nope.
Maybe it's mine, I don't know.